Yes, it's the Mr. Clean Show here, back again, week four. Everything you want to see, Ithaca, the universe, everything. Today I have my friend Basso. We've got an external production segment with my chiropractor, Dr. Brian Bartholomew, that I've been promising you everything. Yes. Now to my friend Basso. Hey. All right, man, we've been talking about doing this since we did that early promo a long time ago. I've been running that a little bit in some of the shows, and I've also come up with a second show, the Primordial Mr. Clean Show, which I'm going to show that jam session. You won't believe it, man. You will not believe it. So would you like to play a song for us? Or Johnny, be good. You gonna sing too? Thank you. Hold on just a second. It gets hot in the studio, I tell ya, hot. Yes. We're going to go to that segment I've been promising you with Dr. Brian Bartholomew. Yeah. Yes, later my co-host and studio director is going to come in here and do some poetry, and then she's going to set up another clip. Everything you want to see in Ithaca, the Mr. Clean Show. Yes.
Hey, we're here at my chiropractor's office, Dr. Brian Bartholomew, and I'm going to actually go through, I've been announcing for 3 weeks that it's going to be on the show. We're going to experience a whole treatment, and it's going to be great, I tell you, for the Mr. Clean Show. Yes! And Dr. Brian Bartholomew. And now we are entering the building. Here we go. Here's where we take off our coats. this treatment has really helped me a great deal. I have a spinal injury that has been persistent with chronic pain, and the treatments have helped a tremendous deal, a great deal. Oop, I better leave my scarf here. Okay, now we have the receptionist place where you just check in this with a little key tag thing here, if I can find it. And the thing is really loud. Ooh, oh, they toned it down a bit. Excellent.
Good.
Hi, good morning. Good to see you.
Thank
I'm
going
to go through my regular treatment. And that's our lovely receptionist that helps us check in, and it's really cool. So what happens is you do a warm-up with this traction that helps prepare the spine for an adjustment. And I think I'll just take off my suit jacket here. And yeah, I should probably take out my whole thing. So you kind of like limber up a little bit. And this kind of prepares the cervical spine for the adjustment. You can, this is actually the right level that it's at, but just to demonstrate, I will release it. So if it's like too loose, then you kind of like pull it about as tight as it can get. And then normally I wouldn't have this microphone, so I just put it in my pocket. And you then pull down to prepare the neck for the right way, and just kind of do a few dips. I think they actually say do like 20 of them, but I usually just do like 5 to 10. This kind of stretches out the cervical spine to get it ready so that it can be adjusted. And so Dr. Brian Bartholomew will be doing an ongoing health segment. So then the next step after you do this traction thing is to come over here to these little swivel-y things. And so now my cervical spine is prepared for the treatment. Now to prepare the rest of my spine is kind of do side-to-side motions. Oh, one thing I forgot is you get a number. I'm number 11. So that I can be in line for treatment. So you do side-to-side motion to prepare, and back and forth. That warms up the spine and gets it ready for, or the doctor can speak more to what it exactly does. In my opinion, it's just kind of, or from my limited knowledge, is just kind of warms up the spine and prepares it for, then you do like a V8. This is a little hard. Once you get the hang of it, around V8. Yes! This has really been helpful. Tremendous pain reduction. I'm sleeping better. This has been an ongoing problem that I've had for 12 years. I was struck in the spine with a rock and it ruptured the disc, and there was like severe sciatica where I could hardly walk at one point. They were going to fuse my spine. But I'm glad I didn't, because that would have been terrible. Once that spine is fused, you are messed up for it. Like the physician that was recommending fusing the spine actually said, oh, it's okay, I've had that operation myself. I can't play tennis the way I want to, but that's all there is. But then within the 6 months that I saw this guy, he had to go in for surgery to have another vertebra fused, because the operations just don't work. But chiropractic is working. So now I'm pretty much ready to go forth with my treatment. Oh, there's still someone in the that area. So I could still do some more warm-ups and ramble on more about. This one is basically the same thing, but I like this because I'm male, and that kind of affects my genital area, like it's got a bulge. And so this has a depression. So they're basically the same thing, only this is kind of more rubbery. Yeah, and it kind of, just like with riding bikes, they say that they found that it affects the nerve leading to the genitalia, and that long-distance bike riders actually became impotent over time. So that's why you see that split in the seat of professional bike riders. We'll have that split in the seat because you don't want to affect that nerve. So I got to keep myself in order. Oh, nope, keep on going. I'll just cut the footage if... All right. Now I think my reserved room is now vacant. Each week he has a little segment that you can read up. A little. This is actually a testimonial that somebody wrote up. Or you'll have a little cool piece of information of nutrition or health. They have a video ongoing over here that gives some educational material. So some other folks that are doing their warm-ups can watch the video. They have, what's your number one priority? Water. Like, I've drank a lot of coffee this morning, so I'm going to get myself some water. Not 8 ounces, 8 glasses of 8 ounce is a day. Bringing it to you, the Mr. Clean Show. Yes! Now I'm going to go over and start. I pretty much warmed up my spine. I didn't really do enough of these, but I rarely do. But it's just to get yourself in order. And also the warm-ups here are cool. Now I'm heading into my treatment area. Yes! So what you do is then prepare your own area for hygiene. They strip this over here and remove some of the hairs. Pull this up, toss it in the basket. Yes! So each week he has a little helpful word of wisdom here. Little handouts, little information about the spine. And now he's usually, when we film the live portion of our program, Dr. Bartholomew is working. So we're going to come in and do like a whole bunch of segments all at once and then run them each week. And then maybe at one point he will be able to come in when we do a live format. So I'm next in line, and what you do is then lay down. My spine is all warmed up and ready for adjustment. And, oh, it'll help if I take my glasses off. I better set those over here. And, so then you can prepare and kind of enter a state of relaxation now that the spine is warmed up. Yes. Here's some of the prescriptions that people have given up. All the toxic meds and stuff that they no longer need. Pain meds, antidepressants, all that. Once the spinal cord is in line, your nerve impulses are going correctly and everything's flowing. And look at this. Look at this. Now over to my treatment. So they moved us over here to this more private area, but it's basically the same thing. You prepare this little place, rip it off, throw it in there. These treatments are really helping. And so she will be filming, my lovely camera person will be filming the actual treatment. Oh, All right, good to see you.
Good to see you, Chris. How's it going, man?
Very good, very good. I'm here to film an actual treatment. I've been announcing for a few weeks that you're going to come out and do a health segment.
Yeah, can't wait.
And so here's the actual treatment. I've done my warm-ups. This is Dr. Bartholomew. And here we go.
So his spine's ready for a good adjustment.
You can talk about it if you want.
So basically, he lays down. We already have, like in the computer, we already have all his information. So we have all his x-rays on file. We have everything, so we know exactly what adjustments he's doing. We have his frequency, have all his notes in there. So he lays face down, he takes a couple deep breaths and relaxes and gets totally in his healing zone, helps those deep stabilizing muscles to get relaxed. So adjustment-wise, let's put that right there. Start with a little bit of drop work, get his hips and pelvis in perfect alignment. These lower nerves go down the legs, they help with digestive tract, help with bladder. So the goal is to remove any interference and help him to be as healthy as possible. Feel right through here, he's way out of place. Good, and then right in this part. Good, this area is really important. It helps with breathing, helps with blood pressure. Just gonna stretch a bit in there to help it hold in place. Good. Have you put this side up, my man? Good. Hips and everything adjusted great. As you know, nervous system controls everything from the brain down through the spinal cord out to all the organs, so we're just removing interference, letting that inborn intelligence, that power that runs it, runs the body, heal the body. You can feel here is way out of place. Good. And right here at the C6, which helps with hands, helps with heart, lungs, thyroid. Switch this up. Good.
And then I also
had a history of some ear issues, so we do a little...
Well, I mean, I quit smoking quite a while back. It was all stuffy sinuses, so this kind of helps.
Helps the eustachian tube with draining. Lightly pull the eustachian tube up. Same thing back here. Good. And then I try my best to talk him into going to one of our seminars so we can teach about nutrition, detoxification. This next seminar is also talking about workouts. We have a nice article there talking about how your adjustments help repair the DNA, help you live longer. Testimonial of the week this week talks about one of our patients who's lost 41 pounds in the first few months. His numbness in his hands have gone away, headaches are gone. So every week we have different testimonials. So
that's something I want to join in on, as I'm noticing like I'm developing the middle age paunch here, so I want to join in on the nutrition element.
So next Saturday morning at 9 a.m. we're teaching about the hormones associated with long-term weight loss. We're teaching about BMI, we're teaching about the proper exercise to get in the shape of your life in 12 minutes or less.
Excellent. Thank you very much, and we'll look forward to the ongoing segments that we're going to have each week. We'll probably do a filming of them all at once since you're busy during our normal live show. And thanks again.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Health, exercise, we're going to do nutrition, we're going to have everything you want to see on the Mr. CleanN Show. Yes! All right, now back from that was a cool segment where he did my adjustment and all that. Now, for Black History Month, we have my co-host and studio director, Verna Jackson, here to do some poetry, some songs, set up a clip, whatever she wants to do. Bringing it to you, the Mr. CleanN Show. Yes!
Thank you, Christopher. Hello. I'd like to say hi to you people out there in television land. I'm Verna Jackson. And I want to wish you a Black History Month celebration. Happy Black History Month. And for Black History Month, I have prepared for you a call out to the children in the ghetto. The children in the ghetto are just, they're not just, because I'm from Chicago, they're not people from Chicago in the ghetto only. The ghetto is truly just a state of mind. I want to remind you people here in Ithaca, New York, that we have children here who are suffering. And they are suffering very seriously. And we need to give the children some relief. We need to help the children as much as we can. Not just Black children, but all children. Black, white, red, yellow. We need to help our children. The children need our help. And I have a children's theater company called the Young Ones New Life Production Crew. And we will be coming to you live right here. But, so if you'd like to get involved with that, Look me up. My number is 708-374-4746. If you have a child that likes to do theater, operate cameras, learn how to do the lighting, whatever they'd like to do, you can call me at 708-374-4746. Now, here we go. Children of the ghetto. Children of the ghetto, I am coming to you. Children of the ghetto, I am singing to you and I'm asking you to be true. Open your mind and do you, and do you. Hey, black child, do you know who you are? Do you know that you could do what you want to do if you try to do what you can do? Ghetto child, meek and mild, wakes up mornings with a smile, happy in a sad, sweet way, yet never expecting a better day. Landlord's beating up on your door. It doesn't matter that it's a shack, but rent is due and you are black. Off to school without a meal. Hunger pains make our children steal. How can they learn to write or read when food is what they really need? Ghetto child into a man. You have grown and now you stand. Meek no more, but neither mild. Screaming and demanding, it's my way now. Children of the ghetto, I am singing to you. Thank you. Happy Black History Month.
Thank you, Verna. That was excellent. Excellent, I tell you, at the Mr. CleanN Show. Yes!
Now, I think we're going to do...
Any easier, does it? All right. I think by the three takes... Show bringing it to you. Hey, do you know Sabbath? We can do Sabbath. Yes.
Cigarettes and all of the stuff.
all this star shit going on. But it sounds good, man. You, I will get some musical guests. My brother's playing good, but I'm not doing so well. Yo!
Technicolor Trailer Park, yes! Trouble will find you, oh yes it will, 'cause it's not that kind of world. Well, it's not that kind of world. No, it's not that kind of world. No, 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 not anymore. In front of the TV. Oh no, kids just don't play anymore. 'Cause it's not that kind of world. Well, it's not that kind of world. No, it's not that kind of world. No, 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 not anymore. Well, it used to be hugs and bunnies, but now it's just guns and lies. Instead of starting wars, I think we should start saving lives. It's not that kind of world. Well, it's not that kind of world. Well, it's not that kind of world. No, it's not that kind of world. No, 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 not anymore. Be the kids would play out in the street. Yeah, yes, sir. know your neighbor. Everybody running around in their iPod bubbles, yeah. You can't even say hi. Though I always try, still I never get no reply.
Yes! That was technical as Trailer Park.
It's a message from God. A message from God, the passenger. Go!
Passenger, and I ride and I ride. I ride through the city's backsides. I see the stars and the skies come up bright. Dim the bright and the hollowed skies. You know you look so good tonight, tonight. Passenger. Stay under glass. I look through the window so bright. I see the stars and the stars come out night. In the bright and the hollowed sky. Over the city's ripping sky. And I see everything looks so good tonight. Passenger, he looks through the window so bright.
Alright, brother.
Robert's got a quick hand. Yeah, he's looking around the room to tell you his plan. How to roll a cigarette the way it should be. Yes, we're gonna do it well the way it should be. Such a long time.
Now we're going to cut to my Quaker friend, John Watts.
All right, we're here with the Mr. Clean Show, splashing coffee all over, and with this friend that I just met just now. And he's going to do a rap performance here at the Quaker Meeting House. What do you have to say? Or what's your name first?
That's right. Well, my name is John Watts, and I'm about to play a show here at Ithaca Friends Meeting. I live in Philly, and I came up just for this. Excited to be here.
Excellent, excellent. So, as I understand it, you travel around and do this, or what?
I do, yeah. I first met the folks at Ithaca Friends Meeting when I was on a bike tour. I rode my bike from Richmond up to Boston and played shows along the way. And, yeah, now I'm in Philly. I play the guitar and I rap, so, and I'm a Quaker.
Excellent. So, we're going to get some songs as long as the tape holds out,
yeah.
And we're going to run it. This is our musical guest for this, an external production for the Mr. Clean Show. Yes!
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 Yeah!
That's, there we go. So I am supposed to introduce our guest, who is John Watts, traveling hip-hop Quaker minstrel. Terms that often do not all line up together, but you will see how they all coexist in an exciting way tonight. John has several albums out. Many of you have seen his, you know, ultra-famous Quaker work, Not a Christian, but I'm a Quaker. Since then, there's been some evolution in topic, and most of the things in his latest project called Clothe Yourself in Righteousness are about what it is to be spiritually naked. So, prepare yourself for some good music, and I think conversation to follow on, yes, on Quakers and Nakedness. You'll love it. Here's John.
Happy to be here. The last time I played for Ithaca Meeting was not in this building. You guys were in a building on a hill, which I think you still have. Yeah? And yeah. I'm glad to see that this building is equally gorgeous. I did just write a really controversial blog post called Sell Your Meeting House, Support a Minister.
Yeah.
Hey, at least I didn't write what Micah Bales did, which is burn your meeting house. I need to apologize. And controversial things. Getting naked. Let's go, that's the whole show. I went to college in North Carolina at Guilford College, which is significantly less cold in the winter. And so at Guilford College, we streaked so often that we created a club around streaking. Every Friday afternoon, a large group of us would get together. We would shed our clothing, and we would run around campus, and the club grew and grew until the college had to make some policy statement about what it meant and whether it was okay. And it was. The security officers would follow our group around and make sure that none of the other students harassed us as we were running around campus. We would run through the library, 30 of us, all naked, running through the library as people were trying to study. I think a lot of that was just rebelliousness and wanting to sort of feel that rush of doing something that's not quite normal. But then my favorite Quaker professor, Quakerism professor, the only Quakerism professor I know, who's my favorite, told me that nakedness, going naked, is actually something that the Quakers have done historically, that the Quakers did in the 17th century. So I felt even more justified in streaking with my streaking club. However, going naked in the 17th century was quite a bit different than streaking with 29 other college students on Guilford College's campus. And I was in a period of time where I was starting to write songs about Quakerism. I grew up Quaker, and I had been a recording artist for a little while. And I started wanting to marry the two. I started wanting to write songs that really was serving people, was a service. That my gift of songwriting could be something that was connecting, something that was educating, something that was deepening. So I started to seek things about Quakerism in the past that excited me or intrigued me or offended me. So I got together with my friend Maggie. We moved to West Philly a couple of years ago, and Maggie had been intrigued by this idea of nakedness also, that early friends went naked. So we had this intention of getting together and writing some of the stories of early friends going naked, trying to figure out what was going on with them, what were they thinking, what were the reasons behind. So this is my story of Solomon Eccles. Solomon Eccles was a friend who went naked through a public market in London in the 1650s. And the context of Solomon Eccles going naked through the Smithfield market in the 1650s was that he was naked and he had a basket of burning brimstone on his head that he was balancing on his head as he went through the streets naked. And something significant had just happened in Solomon Eccles' meeting the day before he decided to go naked through the streets of London. Quakerism, at the very beginning of Quakerism was illegal. It was an act of rebellion just to meet in a Quaker meeting. Because the Church of England was, by law, everyone's church. You had to worship in a certain way. And the church and the government were the same, so you paid your taxes to the church. So just by meeting in Quaker meeting, or any other, the Anabaptists, the Levelers, any of the other religious movements of the time, by meeting in a different church on Sunday morning, you were rebelling against your government. You were breaking the law. So one Sunday morning in London, in the Bull and Mouth Meeting House, Solomon Eccles' meeting, while they were sitting there in worship, in Quaker worship, in silent worship, the police streamed in the doors with batons and started beating people during meeting for worship. broke up the meeting. So Smithfield Market, early in the day, the crowd parts around him and the people fall away. Mothers cover child's ears for fear of what he'll say. He says, I'm naked because we all are, and God sees through this mess. Your identity's a farce before birth and after death. You're not a banker or a lawyer or a well-to-do man. You're just another beggar with outstretched hands, and you could fill them up with beauty. You could fill them up with joy. You could fill them up when times are rough with the glory of the Lord. Wrap yourselves in silks, and you wrap yourselves in blood and hell and guilt. Knowing that he's broken, so let him be naked. Don't avert your eyes. Take it as a sign that it's time to drop disguises. Stop hiding behind silence. Stop hiding behind noise. Stop hiding your own violence. Stop hiding from that still, small voice.
Thank you.
And she's by a stool.
Yes, the Mr. Clean
Show.
Turn in
the Mr. Clean Show. Yes.
Our shadows taller than our souls. There walks a lady we all know, who shines twilight and wants the show.
Roses are red, violets
however
are
things
blue.
Still turns to gold.
Mr. Clean just got diggity down for you. Yes.
Thank you for doing a guest appearance.
I wasn't a guest. I just came from school. And he was the guest, right there.
So how do you feel when things all fuck up like that?
What's that?
How do you feel when things just all fuck up and I can't do vocals and all?
Language. Oh, I get frustrated. I'm like, why am I even on this show? I just want to play the song right, get it done. Not have to worry about it. Now I have to worry about you editing out all those parts that we messed up and stuff. I don't know.
Well, one thing is we could put this on the primordial Mr. Clean Show, which is shown late at night. What do you think?
We blew the speakers, too.
That's fine, because if there's some error that they have a higher voltage of electronics to go into the equipment that blows it out, that's not my problem. I have none but a technician. So that's fully the responsibility of those wiring the sound. And she's buying a stairway to heaven.